Hey guys, welcome back to another video. So in the previous video I have told you that how you can use all the Angular material module in the single page, and that can be used globally. So I hope you have done those. So now today I am gonna tell you how you can open your dialog box. So for example, if you want to create as a login form or something like that, so based on your requirement you can create it, and how you can open your dialog box, that is my concern. So that is my requirement. For example, if I click over here, you are able to see this dialog box is getting opened, right? So today I'm tell you how you can create it. Okay, so first of all I will go inside this folder, I will open it. Instead of keeping all these things, I will clean it. Okay, I will create one button here. Just I will show you step by steps. In this HTML, if you'll go, there is a one button, right? Copy this button, paste it down here, and copy this method, click event, and you paste it. Okay, that's fine. We will keep this one to remove that error. Okay, so now I will call this method. If you'll go to browser, click on that, nothing is happening, right? I'll make this button as a more visible. And then I will put as a color. Oh wow. So it will look pretty cool. So this button you are able to see. So once click on this button, we want to open our dialog box, correct? So what I will do here is, let apply something here. In this tip, I will use container with class container. So now you can see that this is somehow in the center, right? So this look good. So what I will do here, so now on click on this button, we want to open our dialog box, right? So what I will do, I will create a component that will under of app component to make as a good sequence. Click on cd, type as a cd, enter it, go inside and type as a ng generate component. Component name is dialog box. So it's gonna create a one component with the dialog box name. Just wait a moment, it's gonna create inside this app folder. So now you can see this folder has been created here. So what I will do here, so if you'll go inside this app component.ts file, here on click on this one, we have to call the method where we can open the dialog box. So I'm gonna show you in the code. So if you'll go to here, you can see open dialog. So this is gonna call to open this dialog box. Okay, so I'm gonna tell you how it works. So this dialog box means our dialog box. So I will copy from this class, this is our class, I will paste it here, and I will import our reference. You can see, you will able to see the references here. So now this dialog box also supposed to have a some reference, right? So that's comes under, I will create one private here, private this dot, I'll put the same name. So that will be the mat dialog. So from this import it's gonna come. So now what will happen, once you click this button, so this is the button where you have created, click on this one, it's gonna call this method and it's gonna open this component. In this component, whatever it is present inside the HTML, it will visible. So once you click over here, now you can see this is open here, right? So if you want something here as well, so I will put as a one button. So just type me, I will say type as a show. Normal button will come, not a Angular button. So you can see this button is came, right? So this is how it's works. So now I will show you the exactly what looks is there for this one. So what I will do, I will copy this code, I will go and paste it here. So now if you'll see, once it is get loads, so the exact whatever you have seen there, so now it will be visible here as well. So this is how the dialog box is getting open. So for example, if you'll see outside of this dialog box is getting closed, right? This is sometimes it is good, sometimes it's not good, right? So based on the requirement, you can make it as a disable or enable. So, and the second thing, install and okay. So here I will make a change. So I don't want to close it up. So I'll make it as a straight away there. So once you click on install, until and unless something you have not done, so it's not gonna close. So now it is in a stay in the page. It's not gonna close. For example, if you want to create a login form or something, so you can validate based on this click event. So that's gonna help you. So in the click cancel, it's gonna be closed. Correct. So this is how you can open your dialog box. If you want something here, so based on that, see, it's having a separation of class. So this is the mat action. So mat action in the sense, this is the bottom side of your actions. See, if I'll go here, this line of code. Okay, once again. See, entire from here to here, this is the action divider, right? This is the part of action. This is the part, this complete one, it's the part of content. I will show you. So you can see mat content. Mat content having all the things here, right? And this is the mat dialog title. So title is the different div, right? It's having a different separation. So it's gonna look and feel, it's gonna cool. So if you want to use multiple things, you can use inside the action button and all. For example, if you want as a input, so I will show you some example of inputs. For example, you want the first input here, so I will copy, paste it down here. Right, now you can see in the dialog box we are, let load it again. Now you can see this input form is came, right? So based on that, you can put anything as you want. So if you want, so in the next video I will try to tell you how you can create a login form as a simple validation, how you can create it and how you can validate your form, click on event, on submit or login or something like that. Okay, till the time, take care, bye.